fighting over seats. Harry pushed his trolley off down the platform in search of an empty seat. He passed a round-faced boy who was saying, "Gran, I've lost my toad again." "Oh, Neville," he heard the old woman sigh. A boy with dreadlocks was surrounded by a small crowd. "Give us a look, Lee. Go on." The boy lifted the lid of a box in his arms, and the people around him shrieked and yelled as something inside poked out a long, hairy leg. Harry pressed on through the crowd until he found an empty compartment near the end of the train. He got inside first, and then started to shove and heave his trunk towards the train door. He tried to lift it up the steps, but could hardly raise one end, and twice he dropped it painfully on his foot. "Want a hand?" It was one of the red-haired twins he had followed through the ticket box. "Yes, please," Harry panted. "Oi, Fred, come here and help." The twins helped. Harry's trunk was at last tucked away in a corner of the compartment. "Thanks," said Harry, pushing his sweaty hair out of his eyes. "What's that?" said one of the twins suddenly, pointing at Harry's lightning scar. "Blimey," said the other twin. "Are you..." "He is," said the first twin. "Aren't you?" he added to Harry. "What?" said Harry. "Harry Potter," chorused the twins. "Oh, him," said Harry. "I mean, yes, I am." The two boys, and Harry felt himself going red. Then, to his relief, a voice came floating in through the train's open door. "Fred? George?"